Hello all and welcome back. In this video, we are going to cover Amazon DynamoDB backups, followed by a quick demo. DynamoDB Backup and Restore provides a fully automated on-demand backup, restore, and point-in-time recovery of data protection and archiving. DynamoDB currently supports on-demand backups and point-in-time recovery. DynamoDB on-demand backup helps create full backups of the table for long-term retention and archiving for regulatory compliance needs. Backup and restore actions run with no impact on table performance or availability. Backups are preserved regardless of the table deletion and retained until they are explicitly deleted. On-demand backups can be cataloged and are discoverable. On-demand backups can be created using DynamoDB and AWS Backup. With DynamoDB on-demand backups, you cannot copy the backups to a different account or region. AWS Backup is the recommended way to create DynamoDB backups now. AWS Backup is a fully managed data protection service that makes it easy to centralize and automate backups across AWS services in the cloud and on-premises. It provides enhanced backup features and can be used to configure backup schedules and policies and monitor activity for the AWS resources. It can copy the on-demand backups across AWS accounts and regions. It provides encryption using an AWS KMS key that is independent of the DynamoDB table encryption key. It can add cost allocation tags to the on-demand backups and transition on-demand backups to cold storage for lower costs. AWS Backup Vault Lock Policy can help apply from or write once, read many setting for the backups. Point-in-time recovery. DynamoDB Point-in-Time Recovery, or PITR, enables automatic, continuous, incremental backup of the table with per second granularity. PITR enabled tables that were deleted can be recovered in the preceding 35 days and restored to their state just before the deletion. PITR helps protect against accidental writes and deletes. PITR can also back up tables with hundreds of terabytes of data with no impact on the table performance or availability. In this demo, we will perform a backup of an existing DynamoDB table and restore it as a new table. Open the DynamoDB console. We already have a DynamoDB table, movies created, with some data added to it. Choose Backups. Point-in-time recovery, or PITR, provides continuous backups of your DynamoDB table. And when enabled, it maintains incremental backups of the table for the last 35 days. Until you explicitly turn it off. On-demand backup allows the creation of full backups of DynamoDB table for data archiving, helping you meet corporate and governmental regulatory requirements. Let's create our backup for the movies DynamoDB table. From the drop-down menu that appears, it provides options to create an on-demand backup or scheduled backups. choose Create an on-demand backup. Source table is Movies. Default setting allows you to create a backup managed by AWS Backup with warm storage, no expiration, and a default IAM role. Customized settings allow you to create a backup with either AWS Backup service or using DynamoDB. Specify the backup window. Transition rules to specify if you want to transition the backup to cold storage. Configure retention period, backup vault policy, and IAM roles. We will choose the default settings for this demo. We have completed the settings. Let's choose Create Backup. Backup for the DynamoDB table is in progress, and it would take some time. You can see AWS Backup has been activated as well. And the backup has been created and is in the available status. Let's go ahead and restore the backup. Let's keep the table name Movies Restored. When you restore a backup, you can restore the table to the same AWS region or a different AWS region from where the backup resides. It would also give you an option to restore either the entire table or exclude secondary indexes from being created on the new restored table. Tables restored from backups are always created using the DynamoDB standard table class. In addition, you can specify a different encryption mode. Let's use the default role for restoration and go ahead with restoring our backup. The job has been successfully submitted and will take some time for the restoration. Let's check on the AWS backup as well. Navigate to the AWS backup console. And on the left pane, select Backup Vaults. A backup vault is a container that stores and organizes your backups. Your account will always have a default backup vault. We have the Vault ARN, KMS encryption keys, vault lock policies, and the retention period. If you require different encryption keys or access policies for different groups of backups, you can create multiple backup vaults. Within recovery points, we can see a recovery point created for the movies table. A recovery point basically represents the content of a resource, which in our case is the DynamoDB table, at a specified time. Let's verify our table restoration. Navigate back to the DynamoDB console, and we can see the movies restored table created and is in the restoring status. The table has been created with the same configuration in terms of the partition keys, capacity modes, deletion protection, etc. And the table is now in the active status. Let's navigate to the table. And it has almost all the configurations same as the base table. Let's explore the table items. And we have the same four records that we had in the base table as well. So that's it for a quick demo on DynamoDB backups and restore. I hope you liked the demo. Thank you all.
All right, that was it. Thank you for watching. You can check out my website and connect me on LinkedIn and Twitter. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. For any feedback, please leave a comment down below. To see more videos like this in the future, hit the subscribe button. Thank you.